Hello everyone! Welcome to this new video on generating an invoice report as a PDF based on its invoice number in a Blazor Server application using the Bold Reports Report Writer. The Bold Reports Report Writer is a reporting tool that allows users to export reports in RDL format as PDF, Word, Excel, or CSV documents without viewing them. To learn how to create an invoice report in Bold Reports, refer to the video link in the description. I have already installed the .NET SDK on my machine to create a Blazor Server application with Visual Studio Code. So, let's start with the application creation. I run this command with a command prompt to create an application named Blazor Invoice Generator. Once the application is created, I need to install the NuGet packages to add the necessary dependencies. I change the current working directory to the application root folder. Next, I add the boldreports.net.core packages. This NuGet package contains all the dependency packages to add the Bold Reports report writer to the application. Next, I create a resources folder in the www root folder to store RDL reports. Here, I'm going to use the invoice report.rdl file already created, which I've added to the resources folder. You will find the invoice report.rdl file's downloadable link in this video's description. Once the sample report is added, I need to add the API methods to generate the exported document in the controller. To do that, I create a new file name, boldreportwritercontroller.cs in the data folder, and add the ASP.NET Core MVC, input-output operations, and the Bold Reports Writer namespace, making the namespaces directly accessible in the controller file. Next, I add the namespace in class for organizing the code by preventing naming conflicts and structuring functionality. Then, set the route attribute for the Bold Report Writer controller, which allows URLs that follow the pattern to map requests to controller actions. To read the report file from the application, I use the iHosting environment with dependency injection. Next, I add the export method with HTTP GET action for exporting the invoice associated using Invoice ID. In the export method, first, read the report file as a stream to use it in the report writer. I have accessed the already added report using the report path. And copy the file stream to the memory stream. This copy process will be helpful to avoid file access problems in the server while running the application on it. Next, I create a new instance of the ReportWriter class and load the report into the ReportWriter using the created memory stream. I will be generating the report based on the invoice ID number. So, I create a parameter list for the report and assign the invoice ID parameter value to it using the set parameters. Here, the name value should be the same as the parameter name. My report already has this parameter. Next, I generate the PDF using the save option by specifying the PDF format. The generated PDF report will be a stream provided for the file stream result to download on the client side. On downloading, this method will read the stream again for the process, so that the stream position is set back to zero after the save action of the report writer. I then register the license token in the application startup to remove the default license validation message in the PDF. In this demo, I use an online license token. You can get these license tokens from the subscription section of the Bold Reports accounts page. I have provided a link in this video's description to learn more about registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys. Next, invoke the app.mapcontroller function to enable routing to controller action methods, allowing incoming HTTP requests to be mapped to the appropriate actions based on convention or attributes. Next, I will implement the options on the client side to generate the invoice report based on the provided invoice ID. This application will have a text box to get the invoice ID and a button to download the invoice PDF. First, I open the host.cshtml file from the Pages folder and add the necessary scripts. Inside the Script tab, add the Download File method to get the format and set the browser's location to the API endpoint api/boldreportwriter/export with a query parameter specifying the invoice ID. This action triggers the browser to download the PDF file with the specific invoice ID from the export API added in the Bold ReportWriter controller file. Then, I open the index.razor file from the Pages folder, add the code to inject IJS runtime and invoke this JavaScript interop in the index.razor file. I already have the code to build this UI. I add the code. This code will let the text box enter the invoice ID and the generate button. Inside a code, I add the PDF report method. This code asynchronously triggers the client-side JavaScript method download file to initiate a file download. Now, let me run this application. You will see the option to enter the invoice ID and the generate button. I enter an invoice ID and click generate, which will generate the PDF from the API and make it available for the client to view. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.